Hello Devgrammers, I welcome you all to this brand new video. Today we're gonna learn about Git and GitHub. So in this video we will be learning about what is Git, and after that we will be seeing some Git commands with the help of practical and real life examples. Followed by this we will be understanding what is GitHub and what are the different use cases of GitHub. After that we will be seeing how to fork an existing repo, and after that we will be seeing how to clone a repo in your local machine. So let's get started. So let's start with what is Git. So technically Git is a free and open source distributed version control system. Imagine a scenario where you and your four friends are working on some group project, and on the certain time you change the code base. You added one feature or remove one feature, for example. So how will your team members get to know that what is the change you have done? So Git provides some features. With the help of Git, we can track the changes in our source code. So as we have discussed, this is the one purpose of the Git. As you can see, the second feature of the Git, it can be used for the source code management. The next feature is that it allows multiple developers to work together. So as we have seen one examples of you and your friends are working on project. So Git leverages that opportunity. And the last feature and the important feature of the Git is that it supports non-linear development. So you and your friend can work on the same time on your project with the help of different branches. Here as you can see one image, and this image perfectly defines what is Git and what Git can do as a version control system for you. So this was about what is Git and what are the different features of the Git. Now we will see different basic Git commands with the help of some real life examples and the practical examples. The first command is git init. Git init command is used to initialize the empty Git repository in your local machine. So here as you can see, I am in this demo folder. So this folder is currently empty, and if I just have to initialize the Git repo, I have to just press in the command git init. So as you can see, there is one prompt called initialize empty Git repository. So currently you can't see this repo, but if I just press in ls and if I pass in one flag called a, this command shows the hidden files in our folder. So as you can see, there is one .git folder. Next up, git config command. So git config command is used to initially configure your username and user email. As you can see, I have configured it using git config command. I have to just pass in one global flag, after that user.name, and after that I have to pass in my name. Same for the email. These are the different commits in a project. In front of author you can see my name and email. In your case you have to do the same, just pass in your name and email with the help of git config command. These are the prerequisites for you to use Git. Now we will actually play with some Git commands, but before going to the theoretical part, I have to just give you one real life example. So just listen to this example, after that you will be understanding all the Git commands easily. For a moment, let's imagine that your college has organized one speaking competition, and today is the award ceremony of that. The announcers announce that the winner is Shubham. So the first task will be checking the status, where is the Shubham, and is Shubham present on the stage or not. So we are checking the status of the particular file. Git status is related to this. The next task will be bringing Shubham on the stage. After that, we have to just take one picture of Shubham collecting the award. These are the different cases. So the first case was checking the status. The second case was adding or bringing the particular file on stage. And the third was to make the commit or to take the snapshot of what actually happened over there. This is the one analogy with the help of which you can understand the Git commands very easily. So first of all, we will see about git status. Git status tells us the current status of our repository. It can state that whether the file is on stage or not, whether the file has modified or it has been deleted. As you can see, this was our empty project. So if I just check the status of the file, as you can see, there are no changes in our file. But if I make one change, I'll just add index.html file, and I'll just add skeleton of the HTML file in this. And if I just try to check the status now, the status has been changed. Here, the red color indicates that this file is not on stage. So For bringing this file on stage, we have to just pass in git add, after that the name of the particular file. So git add index.html. If I just check the status now, you can see by this green color, this file is on stage. This was the use of the git status and git add command. If we want to track the changes that has been happened in our file, the first stage was to add that file on the staging area, and the second step is to commit that particular change using git commit. The syntax of the git commit will be git commit, after that we have to just pass in one flag, and after that the message that represents what is the change. But to tell what is the change that has been actually happened, we have to commit this change. It is same as saving the checkpoint or taking the snapshot in our file. If I want to commit this change, I have to just type in git commit, after that I have to pass one flag m, after that one message describing what is the change in our file. In this case we have added index.html file, so I'll just write the message index.html added, and if I just press in enter, as you can see our file has been committed. Next up, we are having command git branch. So as we have earlier discussed, we can work on different branches at the same time, but to get to know on which branch git is actually pointing, we will be using git branch command. Now let's understand git branch and its operations. In this image you can see that the green line is the master branch, and for example, let's assume that I am working on feature 1 and my teammate is working on feature 2. Once I confirm that my feature is perfectly working, what I can do is that I will merge my branch to the master branch. Same for the feature number 2. Next up, git reset command. So imagine that your app has 3 to 4 features and we are implementing 3 to 4 features serially. So we have implemented the first feature, after that we have committed that particular feature, after that we have worked on second feature and we have also committed that change, and after that we have worked on the third feature. But what if we want to jump from this commit to this commit? So for this particular task we will be using git reset. So here in our project, just to mimic the condition that we have just discussed, I have added here three features in form of three commits. So if I just press in git log, so as you can see there are four commits. Currently, as you can see, git is pointing on this particular commit. So what if we want to move from this commit to this commit? So for this particular task we will be using git reset, and after that we have to pass in this commit id. Each commit has its commit id. We have to pass in the commit id where we want to jump on. So if I just pass in this commit id, if I just check the git log once again, you can see that currently the git is pointing on the second feature added commit. What is GitHub? So in the simple words, GitHub is the code hosting platform for the collaborations. You can host your code over GitHub very easily, and many of the developers can do the same. GitHub is widely used in the open source contributions, but before pushing our code to GitHub, we have to do some simple steps. One of them is adding a remote. So as we all know, and if you have observed carefully, we are working on the git commands locally on our machine. But to communicate with the outside world, we will be using remote, because we want to communicate with the GitHub repo where we want to push our code. So basically, what is remote? So remote is one repo which is other than the one on your local machine, where we can push our changes before pushing them to the GitHub, so that people can see the changes in the code and they can pull the changes on their local machine. The syntax for the git remote add is that we have to just pass in the remote name, this is origin in this case, and after that we have to pass in remote URL. We will see one demo repo where we want to push our code. So here on GitHub, first we will see how to create a repo and how to push our code on the GitHub. So as you can see, we have to just create one repository. For now I'll just name this as git demo, and I'll just change its visibility to private. So as you can see here, GitHub also provides the steps so that you can push your changes to GitHub. So yeah, as we have discussed, we have to pass in git remote add, after that the name of the origin, after that the name of the remote, and after that the remote URL. So we have to just copy this command, and I have to just paste this particular command in my terminal. So we won't be seeing anything here, but our remote has been added successfully. As we have added the remote successfully, the last step will be pushing our code on GitHub. The syntax of the git push is that after git push, we have to pass in remote name and after that the branch name. In our case, this will be git push origin master. So as we have discussed, git push, after that the name of the remote, which is origin in this case, and after that name of the branch, which is master in this case. So if I just press in enter, you can see our code has been pushed to the GitHub successfully. So as you can see in our git demo repo, the code has been successfully pushed. This was about the basic commands and the practical examples about the different git commands. Now we will see how to make a duplicate copy of an existing public repo. For a moment, just assume that you like this particular repo and you want to make the duplicate copy, your personal copy of this particular repo. So for that part, we will be using forking. So to fork this repo, you have to just press in this fork button, and I just press in create fork. So as you can see, the personal copy of that particular existing repo has been created in my account. So in this way, you can fork any repo which is publicly available on GitHub. This was about forking the existing repo. Next up, what if we want to clone any particular repo in a new directory or another location? For a moment, just assume that the fork that we have created, if we want to clone this particular repo in our local machine, we will be using git clone command. I am again in this empty folder called demo, and I'll just type in git clone, and after that we have to just pass in the URL of the particular repo. For getting that URL, you have to just go here. For a simple purpose, we will be using HTTPS method. We have to just copy this URL, and we have to simply paste this particular URL. And if I just press enter, as you can see, the particular git repo has been cloned in our local machine. All the files are here. In this way, you can clone any public repo. Alright, so this was about today's video. Thank you for watching and subscribe for more content like this. Until that, keep learning and keep developing.